The visit aimed to witness firsthand the outcomes of American investments in various sectors crucial to Uganda's development, particularly in healthcare, education, and infrastructure.
Our PEPFAR program, we have continued on an annual basis, and I anticipate we will continue to do so in the future to provide the medicines that the individuals here are picking up today and can so do so free of charge. All the service is free. People can get tested, they can get medicines. These are things that the United States has supported through our PEPFAR program, we are fully committed to continuing to do so.
The ambassador visited several healthcare facilities that have benefited from American assistance, which amongst them included Fort Portal Regional Referral Hospital, Yahweh Foundation, among others. He highlighted the pivotal role of healthcare in promoting economic prosperity and social progress, emphasizing the importance of collaborative efforts in tackling health-related obstacles.
I'll start by saying nationally, throughout Uganda, our assistance is nearly $1 billion. Of that, about $550 million a year is health programs. A significant portion of that is particularly for the prevention and treatment of HIV, but also for fighting malaria, fighting other infectious diseases.
The American ambassador, however, expressed concern at the HIV/AIDS infection rate, which have remained steadily increasing despite different interventions put in place to have the rates reduced.
I got in the United States working to lower the incidence of HIV overall. And of course, under our program, which we call PEPFAR, our goal is to reach 95% of all people knowing their status, 95% of those people at least on treatment, and at least 95% of those people who are on treatment having their viral load suppressed.
Records from the Uganda AIDS Commission in 2023 indicate that Fort Portal Tourism City has the highest HIV infection rates at 17.8% in the country. This indicates that there was an increase in the infection rates, which previously stood at 14.6%, and placing Fort Portal in the second place after Kalangala District with the highest infection rates in the country.
Have economic opportunities, again, learn skills to get connected with employment opportunities so that they can first and foremost have income and revenue that makes them less vulnerable to being in situations of sexual exploitation, having to be involved in prostitution or other circumstances that could make them vulnerable.
Story by Jonathan Singure for the News in Fort Portal.